Para ella, alguien que lo va a curar es alguien que le va a rezar, que va a prender una vela, le van a quitar los malos espíritus. Cuando un indígena acude a un hospital, pues la gente se siente perdido, ¿no?
Shamans, who heal with prayers and medicinal plants, are often a first stop for people seeking medical care in the highlands of Chiapas, Mexico. Many here only visit government hospitals in case of emergencies for fear that doctors and nurses won't respect their language and customs. Many of those instead turn to Sergio Castro, or as he's better known, Don Sergio.
Las personas que acuden conmigo son personas que en cierta forma los hospitales los han desahuciado, ¿no? Y piensan que conmigo van a tener alguna posibilidad o una curación más efectiva, ¿no?
In 1966, Castro began working in Chiapas as an agronomist and veterinarian. He witnessed alarming conditions in many of the villages and decided to help by building schools and water treatment systems. He also taught himself how to heal long-term wounds. Now, at 72, he treats over 100 cases a week, either at his clinic or at patients' homes.
¿Cómo te diré que Dios me dio algo especial para en mis manos el poder hacer ese trabajo?
La humildad que tiene Don Sergio para tratar a las personas que no... Yo creo que en cada vez que pasa las manos nos da ánimos para seguir viviendo o decirnos, mira, sigue adelante, échale ganas. Es algo mágico.
Lloraba como me trataban en hospital.
No, sentía yo como despreciado, como humillado con los doctores me sentía yo porque no me querían ahí.
Over the past decade, Mexico has increased spending on healthcare and expanded its reach. But some doctors in the country's remoter regions say that hospitals remain understaffed and overcrowded. Such challenges are exacerbated by a lack of trust across cultures.
Se queja la gente, sí se queja. Sí se queja porque nunca hay espacio. Somos un hospital donde recibimos 17 municipios, diferentes etnias, diferentes tradiciones, diferentes religiones. Y efectivamente tiene que ver esa desconfianza. Que lo que nos queremos es ganar la confianza de la gente. O sea, que la gente venga y se sienta en casa.
Esos son acuerdos entre las dos instituciones. No, porque es un...
Los accidentes son la pólvora, fuegos artificiales, la borrachera, las crisis epilépticas y accidentes pues ya ocasionales en la casa, ¿verdad?
These are people that can't get to a hospital, don't trust the hospitals, don't have the money. If they didn't have Sergio, they would probably encounter some significant disability.
The case of Mariano Lopez was one of Castro's most desperate. Lopez was suffering from a terminal condition when he first came to Castro's clinic. As Lopez lost mobility, Castro began visiting him at home. He used his limited resources and dignified hospice care to ease his pain.
When I saw the work that he did with what little supplies he has, I was astounded. It's pretty challenging. I mean, he is always in desperate need of funding.
Castro refuses payment from his patients and instead counts on donations from tourists and the help of a small network of volunteers. Many of his patients have donated ceremonial clothing to his small museum, which is located inside his clinic.
Yo creo que lo más importante decirle a la gente que vieran un poquito por sus semejantes, ¿verdad? Ama a tu prójimo como a ti mismo, ¿eh? El tratar de amar al prójimo me da cierta tranquilidad, ¿no? Es decir, me siento bien.